Oh, hello. Welcome into my workshop and welcome to the show Creations of Clay. My name is Louis Palladini, and today I'd like to do an animal that everyone is familiar with. It's called a tiger shark. And, you know, it's a dangerous shark, but I think the great white is a little more well known. This is what it will look like, and I'll just kind of spin him around so you can get a good look at him. What's interesting about this shark is the snout on a tiger shark is a lot more like square or blunt than it is on a great white shark. I'll show you the types of clay that you can use. There's an oil-based clay such as this, which never hardens. You can use this multiple times. I used to use this all the time as a kid, and then when I get tired with it, I just roll everything up into a ball again and make something else. There's also an air-hardening clay such as this, which never hardens. Well, this one, it hardens in a couple of hours or overnight. And what it does is you can paint it so it becomes permanent. So my preference for the clay is a clay called Super Sculpey, which can be fired in the oven about 275 degrees for about 15 or 20 minutes. It becomes hard. So it doesn't become hard unless you fire it in the oven like that, but it's great for detail. I'll show you the size balls of clay we'll be using today. I'm gonna make it simple today. I got two balls of clay here on the side, as you can see right here. See these? I got my fingers on them. Those are the size balls we're going to use for the fins on the side. This is going to be used for the dorsal fin on the back. And then these two right here will be used for the tail of the shark. So I'm going to show you how to do that. For the first thing that we're going to do is going to work on the body. So I'm going to put these balls of clay down here. Put them in a particular order so I remember which goes where. I'm going to take this ball of clay, right, and I'm going to take, and we're going to, it's almost like a giant potato. I'm just squeezing it, and what I'm trying to do is make this section here will be made into the tail, and this section will be the head. So I'm going to just continue to squeeze it. Just going to keep working it like that. Just like that. See how we're... It's starting to take shape. I'm going to do that. And we'll just keep trying to lengthen it out a little bit. See how this is going to actually be the tail, and that will be the head. But see how I'm lengthening it out. Just like this. This way we can, it's an easy way to make a tiger shark. Now we're gonna start to work on the head here. So I'm lengthening that, but as I'm making it, see, I'm gonna take and try to round it a little bit there. Kind of square it off a little bit. See how I'm doing that? That's the shape that we're working for. So that's what it's going to look like from the side. This is what it looked like from the front, and that's what it looked like from the other side. So I want to see. Yeah, it's about the right length right now. See that? So I'm going to put this back down. So what I'm going to do too is kind of smooth it a little bit with my thumb. See, I'm taking my thumb and going over it like that. Kind of smooth it out a little bit. Get rid of any of the imperfections in the clay. That we'll just kind of work it like that, just like that. Take our thumb and just kind of work out the imperfections. Just like that. Now what I also want to do too is I want to flatten the bottom a little bit. So I'm going to take this and place it on the table like this. Because when we finally finish with it, I want to be able to rest on the table without rolling over. So that worked out pretty good. And on the tail here too, we're going to pinch it a little bit. See, I'm pinching it on the top a little bit. And then on the bottom, we'll pinch it a little bit there too. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to make the actual tail. So we're going to pick up the shark. We're going to take the two balls of clay and make this part of the tail. See that? And I'll show you how we're going to do that. We're going to take this right here. So what I'm going to do is take this ball of clay and start to flatten it out between my fingers. But I'm also going to make the shape of the tail. See how I'm... making the tail. Flatten it out. But see now, I'm making that shape, that particular shape. Take my fingers and just kind of making the shape of the tail. See that? So you flatten this way. Then you flatten from this side. But then you also want to make this. And that's the particular shape. See that? That's what you want. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the bottom part of the tail. And I'm going to take this, see how we flatten it out? Just like that. But now, it's almost triangular, the way we're doing it. See how this? So I'm flattening that like that. But then, we're making that shape right there. We're doing that like that. So flatten. And then you want to take and use your fingers to go to the other part there. What I'm going to do is I want to compare it to our previous model. Yeah, it looks like it's about right. See that? Well, I'll show you. Pick it up so it makes it a little easier to see. See that? And then we got that right there. So it's approximately the right size. So the next thing that I want to do is take this tail and attach it right there. So I'm going to take and push it in like that. And then I'm going to take and go from both sides with my fingers. I want to make sure that's attached really well. See that? You want to make sure that that's really attached well. See that? We'll go back to the other side. You want to make it so it looks like that was always, they were always part of each other and that you hadn't attached it. So see that? See how I did that? Now what we're going to do is we're going to take and attach this from the bottom. Attach this piece from the bottom here. I'm going to flip that again, okay? And just work that in like that. And then come back to the other side and work those two pieces together. And then there's also something I want to add that I didn't have on my original model. There is, I think, a little ball of clay. You see that? See that? We're going to take that And I'm going to add this up here. It's almost like a little notch. And I'm going to take see that? It's like a little notch. So what you want to do is just kind of flatten it out here, then take one of your fingers and kind of put it up underneath there. And that's what you want to add. You see how that's starting to really take shape? The next thing that we want to do is I want to see, we're going to put the dorsal fin, which is the next thing that we want to do is this dorsal fin here. And we want to put that up there, but I want to make sure I'm putting it approximately the right location. So the dorsal fin will be right about here. So what I'm going to do is, see that ball of clay? Take that and we're going to attach that like that. Now we're going to see, I'm starting to kind of make it like a triangular shape there. Just like that. See, you're squeezing it from this side. See, I'm flattening that. I'll turn it around. You're flattening it from both sides like that. But in the meantime, when you're doing that, you're making this shape here for that dorsal fin. And then what I also want to do too is, see this? Take the clay and work it in like that. You want to make sure it looks like it was actually part of the shark to begin with. So you take that and you work that in like that. See how we're doing that? Just like that. See that? That's what it looked like from the top, the middle, the back. But this is the shape that you want right here. Now, I have some extra clay over on the side. We're going to be making some other fins. And I'll show you. We have some fins here. We've got a fin down bottom here. We've got two right here on the bottom. And then you got another one right here at top. So what we're going to do is we're going to add those. But I didn't make balls for those yet. So what I'm going to do is we're going to take the clay here. I'm going to take this. And I'm going to make little balls of clay for that. So I'm going to put these on the table so you can see them, see? Just like that. And we're going to do about four of those. Okay, so what we're going to do, now that we got that done, I'm going to show you. We're going to add one of the fins. We'll flip them over. We'll do the bottom one first. See this right here? I'm going to take, I want to see where it's going to be on my model. See if I got it approximately the right place. Yep, I do. So we're going to do, like I said, you flatten from one side. I'll show you right here. See, I'm flattening that with my fingers. Just like that. And then we kind of make that triangular shape. We're going to work this I'm going to go all around with my fingers to make sure it's properly attached. And then we're going to do the next one. So the next one is going to be on top. I'm going to put that approximately right here. See that? So take, flatten. Flatten from either side like that. And then we take and go like that. And then we want to kind of work this down, make sure it's properly attached. Go all around. See how that's really coming along? And then we've got two more fins that we have to put on. So I'm going to kind of take and flatten these on my fingers right now. Flatten that. See that I'm doing that? But then you want to make this shape here. So what we're going to do is it's approximately going to be put right here. So I push that in like that. And we just work that in. See how we did that? Go all the way around, work it. And now we're going to take, we're going to do the other side. So what I'm going to do is take I'll make the other one. See that? Flatten from one side. And then you start to make that shape there. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to put that on the other side like that. So I'm going to take, press it in, and see, make sure we work it in. Attach it. See, just in a few short minutes, all the extra fins that we put on there, he's really starting to take shape. The next thing that I want to do is show you how to make, I'll show you. We're going to make these two fins right here. See that? We're going to make those. So I'll show you how we're going to go about that. I'm going to take these two pieces here. So take, flatten out like we have been doing with the others. But then when you're doing this side, start to create the shape of the fin, which should look like this. See that, how I'm doing that with my fingers? Very simple. You're starting off with a very simple clay ball, and then you're creating this really nice shape. And everything really starts to take shape, and you start to say, oh, it's starting to look like a shark. So we do that. See, I'm flattening that out nicely with my fingers. Just like that. But then I'm going to take and compare it to my other model here. I want to see that the fins are about the right size, which they are, approximately the same size. And I'm going to take and make the second fin. So see, I'm making, flatten it out like a pancake. See that? But now I'm taking and creating that point up here. So we're creating that fin. Just like that. So flatten a little bit like this. Flatten around the edges. Just like that. But then we want to make the nice shape like this. just like that. So I'm going to compare these. I want to see that they're approximately the same size, which they appear to be. So now I'm going to do this. I'm going to flatten it a little on the edge here because I'm going to have to attach it to the side of the tiger shark. I'm going to do the same thing with this one. Kind of flatten that a little bit with my finger so we can attach it. But now I got to figure out exactly where I want to place them. So if I do it based on this, my model here, I want to have it approximately here, right there. See that? And I'm going to take and go all the way around and kind of work that into the side of the shark. You want that to really grab onto the shark. So you push down, then take your finger and kind of work that clay up like that. Just like that. See how we did that? So that's what he'll look like from the side. See that? See how nicely that was done? Very simple. Very simple and basic. We're going to do the same thing on the other side of the shark. So I'm going to look here and see this is approximately the same location. See that? And we take and we go all the way around the shark and make sure that that fin is on there nice and tight. We don't want it to come off. Push it into the side of the shark. See how I did that? This is really, really starting to come along nicely. The shark. Look at all we've done in just those few minutes. You really can see how he's starting to really, really take shape. The next thing that we want to work on is I'm going to work on the mouth area and the, let me see, I'm going to get some of my tools out. And I want to see the head. See how the head is kind of square? That's the way a tiger shark looks. It's not as pointed as on the great white. But I do want to figure out where I'm going to put his eyes. So I'm going to take this tool here. I'm going to look at this guy here. And I know exactly where we're going to put the eyes. We're going to put them right about here. See that? Got that. Now what I want to do is I want to look to the other side and make sure I'm doing it in the same spot. So it's going to be right about there. See where I'm making that? And then, and also on the snout, there's a couple of different nostrils that are here. I'll use a smaller point for that. There's a nostril there, and a nostril there on the tiger shark. And then what we want to do is I want to start working on the mouth. So I'm going to take and just kind of work on it. Make the line. I'm working that because we're going to actually open it up. See how I did that? Now, I'm going to put my finger in his mouth a little bit. So now, I'm going to take this tool. Now that we got his mouth open a little bit, and just kind of work that in there, kind of round it out a little bit. One of the things I want to do too is I want to take this and actually stick it down his throat to make a hole there, because when I fire this in the oven, I want to make sure that it doesn't crack. See how we made that mouth? How I pulled it open? Now what we're going to do is we're going to add a few teeth. So I'm going to take some very small balls of clay. And I'll put them down here. Now you can kind of see that the small level that we're working at right now. It makes it harder to work with, but the results are phenomenal when you're done. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is take this tooth and so flatten it, then go from both sides like this. See that? That's what we want to do. I'm going to do five of those. So let me. Sometimes they want to stick to your fingers. So flatten from one side and then make the two. See that? And I'm going to put that on the table. So for the top part of the mouth, I'm going to take, I'll probably use just going to place, try to open that up a little bit more. I'm going to place the tooth there. So I just place those in the mouth, very small. Place that in like that. Now what I want to do, see how I place those teeth in there? I want to take this and I'm going to kind of press those up against the I want to make sure I work them in there really good so they don't come out. And now what I'm going to do for the bottom part of the jaw, I want to kind of almost make a little indentation here where I want to put the teeth. Just like that. So, what I'm going to do is place the teeth like kind of like in that little indentation that I made. See that? Okay, we're almost there. Almost there. And now I'm going to work those teeth in so they stay in. Now, I want you to look at that. See those teeth? Pretty cool, huh? The next thing that we want to do is I want to do the gill slits. And those are going to be here. And we're going to make over 5 of them. So what I'm going to do is go 1, two, three, four, five. See how we did that? And I'll do the same thing on the other side. Make sure I'm making them the same spot, roughly. Let me see, I want to make sure. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See how we did that? The gill slits. The next thing that we want to do is I want to make, we're going to work on the eye again. So I'm going to take it and rotate that a little bit more, like that. And then we're going to go to the other side and do the same thing. Just like that. And then what we're going to do, and I also, before we finish that, I want to poke some holes in the bottom here, because when I fire this in the oven, I don't want it to break or crack. So by doing this, it helps the gases escape from the clay so it doesn't crack when you're firing it in the oven. The next thing we want to do, I'm going to put this down on the table, and I'm going to make a couple of eyes. Move these out of the way. I'll just drop them on the table. They're approximately the right size now. So all I want to do is take this. Might be, you know what? I do want to make this a little deeper because I'll do the same thing over here. So now what we can do is we can take this ball of clay. You know what? It's still a little too big. Sometimes when you make it, you got to take a little more clay off it. You got to make it a little smaller. And that's exactly what I'm going to do here. And I'll make it round again. See that? How I put that in there? We're going to do the same thing for the other side. I'm going to take a little more clay off this one. And we're going to place it in right in there. See that? Just like that. Now, the next thing that I want to do is we're getting pretty close to having this done, so I'm just going to scratch them up a little bit. Put some scars on them. You know, because when they're in the ocean, they do fight with a lot of other animals and things, and they chase prey. So I'm just going to make some scars on them, especially around the nose area, too. Because I'm sure when they grab animals, the animals are still struggling when they do try to eat them. And so I'm going to take and do that. Rough that up a little bit. I'm just going to go along the shark like that. See that, how I'm doing that? Then I also want to kind of pull the tail up a little bit. I want to have it kind of go up a little bit. So when I do fire it, when this comes down a little bit, it won't damage the tail that I worked on. So I do want to show you what the final version of the shark will look like. This is the final version of the tiger shark. See? We did add that little notch that was up here. I don't have it on this one, but I have it on that one. And see how we did all the little fins that are there? Show you, I'll rotate them around. We got the dorsal fin here. We got the fins right here on both sides. We do have the gill slits. There's five on each side. You got the eye right there. And then you can see we do have the teeth that were in the mouth there. And this is the other side of the tiger shark. And it did come out pretty well. I'm very happy with the results tonight. And I do want to thank you for coming to Creations in Clay tonight. And I do look forward to seeing you again next week. Goodbye for now.